All right, good morning, everyone. Julie Sederny here for a live Facebook Live workout. We're gonna do strength today. I've got my assistant, my daughter Phoebe, doing the filming. So I make no promises. The qualities, technical qualities, neither here nor there. So we're gonna take it to knees up, just to get warmed up, reach and pull. Now this is a very typical class that I would teach in one of the various gyms that I work at. Just for strength, we're not doing any real cardio here, but hopefully you'll get your heart rate up. I'm gonna use weights in a couple of the movements. If you don't have weights around, no problem. Let's take the knees wide. You can just use a can of beans or nothing at all. You're still gonna get an effective workout, I promise. Knees up nice and high, stay nice and tall. All right, bring the feet hip width apart. We're gonna squat it down and up. Now on the squat, you wanna make sure that you're add some knees up right here, squat right knee, squat left. Good, now we're gonna add a twist, squat, rotate. Start side of the wall. Give me a few more. Really rotate from the center. Two more. Good. We're going to do a side lunge to a back lunge. Other side. Side lunge, back lunge. The key here is to make a nice big step, nice brave step, pushing through the floor of that foot that's moving. Side lunge, back lunge. Lunge, back. You can always tap in between. Just a few more side and back. Side, back. Good. Shake it out, shake it out. All right, we're going to stand. Go back. Give me a deep breath in. We're going to do a forward fold. Half lift, lengthen through the spine, stretch your head forward. We're gonna walk our hands out to plank. Right here, walk them out. All right, now in your plank, you wanna establish that nice flat line from head to heel, straight spine, pelvis tucked under, glutes are squeezed, shoulder blades together. You wanna avoid at all costs letting that head fall down or the hips coming up or the hips go down, but I rarely see this. This is what I tend to see. You want to straighten it out. Bring your chest forward. Now bring the right foot to the right hand. Reach. Hand down. Foot back. Left foot up. Reach. You want to stack your shoulders in that reach. Let's do a few more. Step forward. Keep the hips low. Down. And back. Up. Reach. Down, back, one more each side. Reach long, hand down, foot back, take it up, reach. All right, we're just gonna do singles with the right foot and the left. Couple more here. You can step wide outside that hand. If you only get this far, that's fine. One more. Walk the hands back to the feet. Roll it up. Great, take a deep breath in. And exhale, great job. All right, we're gonna start. We're gonna do some plie squats. Now you can start, I'm gonna have 5 and 8 pound weights here. You can start heavy, then drop the weights when you need to. If you have the weights, you can start with, yes. I've got my 5. Get that neutral stance with the feet. Arms, step it together. Now step it out left. Now you get the juice here, the gist rather. We're gonna add some juice to this. Morning juice. One more. Step it together. Take it out right. Pulse. Step it in. Step it out. You wanna stay nice and tall. Don't lean forward. The tendency here here is to kind of lean forward. You want to tuck that pelvis, stay nice and tall. Drop the hips. Down, down, up. Press the hips down, step wide. A couple more here. Good. And this one, drop the weights down to your thighs. Tuck the pelvis, press that upper back behind you. We're just gonna pulse it out. Little pulses in the plie. We're gonna go back to some arm work. I'm just giving the shoulders a little break here while we fire up the quadriceps. Hopefully you feel it. I certainly do. Arms out, palms up. We're gonna slowly rotate to a lunge, bringing the weight with, then the other side. On a lunge, I want you to drop that back knee. Okay, don't lean forward. Here's what I don't want. Stay low, chest up. Slight bend in the elbow to help you out. Should feel a lot of engagement through the shoulders, through the core, over and back. A couple more. Good, good. Two. One more. Ooh-wee. Take it up. Hopefully you got the shoulders fired up there like I did. All right, we're gonna take one weight in the right hand. We're gonna do some kind of a variation of what we just did. With left arm out, we're gonna step out to a squat. This one is more of a parallel squat. So the chest is gonna come a little bit forward. You're gonna come down. You're gonna curl, press, curl, release, and then step together. Keeping that left arm static, just floating in the air. Four, three, step it out, right. Squat, curl and press. Squat down, curl and press. Now, there's a lot going on here. It's hard to remember to really sink low. Phoebe, can you turn it up just a little bit on the volume? Just so we can have some entertainment here, other than me. Good, good. More this side. Last one. Good. Take this right leg back. Weight in the right arm. Extend overhead. We're going to pull that back knee up to the elbow. Sink it back to a lunge. The key in the lunge, I want you to get as much out of this as you can. That means you got to drop that back knee. Bend it and drop it. But stay nice and tall. Spine is neutral. Take it in. In two. Up and press. Good, good. I like to work in multiple planes. This is more functional than just working across one joint. Get a lot more done, a lot faster here. Much more efficient. Two more. More. Drop that arm. We're going to pulse it down. Three, two, bring the back knee up. Pulse it down. Drop the knee. Lift tall. Down and lift. Relax the arms for now. Get to the other side. Just a second. Or two or three. Singles. Down, lift. Should start feeling that left hip. Air it up. Drop it. Lift. One more. Good. Shake it up. We got all that on the other side. Right arm out. Stepping out to the left with a curl and press. And four, three, two. Squat down. Let's go. Down and press. Down and in. Curl. Press. Curl. Don't just let the curl speak for itself. Really engage. Squeeze the bicep. You got it. Anyone that knows me knows I'm not a big fan of working the biceps. This tends to be as much as I want to do. Because the biceps engage through most movements with the upper body, right? You don't technically in my opinion, have to give them a whole lot of special attention, but we're gonna serve some, don't worry. Good, a couple more. Three more. Two more. That back leg back, weight in the right arm, back knee low, bring it up to meet the elbow, and down. Nice and slow, and control is the name of the game. Nice and control. I like slow movements. It prevents you from using momentum, hiding bad form. You want to really focus on precision, control. Good. Ooh, feel that shoulder. We got a couple more. Two more. If you've been to my class, you know a couple means four. Last one. Drop the arm, pulse it down. Lift the knee to the chest. Drop the knee down. Lift it to the chest. You can kiss the floor with that knee if you want. Get really low. Yes. The lower you go, the harder you work. And where are we working here? The right hip. Yes, indeed. This leg is pretty much for show. Right about here. Single it out. Come on, eight. Down and up. Seven. Six, drop that knee. Four more. Three, two, and one. Shake it out, grab a drink. You should be nice and toasty by now. We're gonna move on. We're gonna do a inchworm type movement. We're gonna walk our hands out to plank like we did in the warm up. We're gonna do a push up to a side plank, right to left, then walk our hands back to our feet. You're gonna stay low, you're never standing all the way up. So, I'm not too concerned about the music here, but I'll try and time it so it makes sense. At the back of your mat, or the floor, wherever you are, roll it down. Lock your hands out, set up your plank. Bring your shoulder blades together, push up. Lift the right arm. Push up, lift the left arm. Walk those feet back to the feet. Walk the hands back to the feet. Stay here, get a little stretch of the hamstring. Walk those hands back out to plank. Push up, left. Now you can see I'm stacking my feet. That's the most challenging. Walk the hands back to the feet. Alternatively, walk the hands back out. You can stagger the feet, push up, turn it right, push up, turn it left. See how I'm staggering my feet? Walk the hands back to the feet. Your other modification, of course, is to go down to those knees, push up and lift, push up. Notice my hips are not in the air, they're flat. Watch what I do not want. This is what I don't want. With the hips up, you want to bring the chest forward. Gaze forward. Never tuck the chin under in a plank. Walk it back. Walk it up. Push up left. Push up right. Walk those hands back. We're going to do a few more. Take it up. Push up right. Push up left. Walk those hands back. Walk the hands back out. Flatten it out. Push up left. Push up right. Hands back to the feet. Okay, can you do one more each side? Come on, walk it out. Push up, lift right. Push up left. You can always walk those hands back and just sit in child's pose. Right, walk it out. Push up left. Push up right. Like how I showed you that modification at the very end. Walk the feet back, hands back to the feet. Roll it up. Woo! That didn't get you sweating. I'm not quite sure what will. Get around a drink. All right. Shoulders should be toasty. Towel off. All right, we're gonna go into chair pose with some WM arms. So when we walk down to push up, we're working through our entire shoulder carriage, of course, our entire core, even into the legs. This time we're gonna sit into a chair pose, right? So you sit the hips back, and naturally the chest is gonna come forward, right? So you wanna start there, then correct. Lift the chest, tuck the pelvis under, and try to sit a little lower. All the weight is in the heels. I'm wiggling my toes the whole time. Grab your weights. We're gonna have wide elbows from chair pose. Watch me. We're gonna press, make a W, flip to an M, press behind. Lift, flip, press up. Keep those shoulders pressed down away from the ears. All the weight stays in the heels, no matter what's happening up top. Sit a little lower, maybe. You can always stand this up if you need to take a little break in the legs. Tuck that pelvis under. Biceps by the ears. Weights behind the butt. Press it. Push, pull. Push, pull. You got it. This one's deceivingly difficult. I've got 8 pounds. You don't even need any weight to make this one start to warm it up. Flip, press, in, up. Good, shoulders relaxed. Last 2 sets. Last one. Ooh, I feel the shoulders warm. And you're done. Put those weights aside. No one always gets me. All right, we're gonna do a walking plank with a shoulder tap. So get those shoulders ready again. Walking plank for this purpose means going from high plank to low plank to high plank with a little simple shoulder tap in between, okay? Now you can always drop the knees, but here's what you can't do. You can't lift the hips. So this is not a plank of any sort. If you're modified, hips are way down, glutes are squeezed. Weight is forward, right? Or you're here. See the little difference between modified and full? It's not full and modified with the hips up, right? So let's gather our breath. We're starting high. Walk it down, right, left. Take it up. Shoulder tap for 4. 4, 3, down, right, left, right, down, left. Just keep it interesting. We're going to alternate our lead. Down, right, left, up. Now here, try to keep the hips level. Try not to rock the hips up, right? Keep them nice and flat. Squeeze your glutes. That's going to really gear up the core. Down, down, up, up, tap. You can sit back in child's pose whenever you need a little break, then come back and do a little bit more. That's how you progress. Don't just stop. A few more. Down and down. Up and up. Tap. Woo-wee. Down, down. Up, up. Tap, tap. Take it all the way back. Sit it low. Press the hips back. Nice. We're going to stand it up. I like to alternate between levels, high to low. That jacks up the heart rate just in and of itself without even having to jump around. We're gonna do slow-mo runner's lunges. The form on here is critical. These will pay off in spades. I promise you, you're gonna plant your right foot. It's not gonna move. We're gonna get down to that starting position, right? You're in a race. You're about to take off. when you're about to take off. Are you down here resting? You're primed and ready, chest up, sinking the hips down, bending the knees. We're gonna creep that left foot forward to back, keeping our head at the same level, yes? All right, let's try it out, front to back. Really slow, front and back. See how I'm gliding? I'm not coming up and down, I'm staying down. Now, this doesn't seem like much at the beginning, right? First, you wanna really root your feet through the floor here. Press into the ground with that left foot. Push and push. Now I'm gonna get a little lower and try to touch the ground, but notice I'm not coming up and down, I'm staying that low the whole time. They're not full lunges, they're kind of like half lunges from what we did in the beginning, but you should start to feel a lot of heat building right now in your right quad and your right hip. I feel it. So now, let's do eight more. When you start to feel that burn, that's your opportunity. You're going to make a difference, but you gotta push through it a little bit more. Make yourself work a little bit harder. Give me four more, I lied. We're gonna do four. No, I didn't lie. Three, did I? Sometimes I talk too much. Two more. You should feel like that leg's about to give out. Shake it out. Woo! We're gonna go to the other side. If you did not feel like that leg was about to collapse, or you had to stand up, then you need to get a little bit deeper. Have your chest a little bit taller. Take it forward, oops, and back. There we go. So the left leg is planted, the right leg is moving. Now I can be up here. It's the same position, right? Just not quite as deep as being here. It's just the depth, but the form of the movement stays the same no matter how deep you are. Push through the floor, push. Push. You're probably going to feel this a little bit faster on this other side because it's not like the other leg wasn't doing anything. It was working. I feel my quad fired up. I hope you do too. This is when you know you're making a difference, right? That's what real fatigue is. Push yourself to the point where you really can't do another one. Feel what fatigue means in your body. And that's gonna help you in all of your workouts. Because then if you just push ever so slightly past that point of fatigue, that's where you progress. Come on. Now I'm feeling the burn really set in. And I can do, now I can do a few more. Good. Two more sets. Forward. Last set. Ooh, shake it out. Oh, that's a good one. Grab a drink. Your heart rate should elevate quite a bit there. We're working into those really big muscle groups, getting into them intensely. Jacks up the heart rate. There's no reason why you should not have my little assistants are coming down. There's no reason why you should not have your heart rate racing doing a strength workout. If you're not, you're probably not doing enough to make a real difference, okay? Right, next. We're gonna take it all the way down. We're gonna isolate triceps. Feet. That's good. All right, I'm gonna let you rest for a second. Bottom arm is gonna tuck under. Raise the top arm up. Who wants to do triceps? We do. Put that hand right next to the shoulder. We're just gonna press through the palm of that top arm. That's all we're gonna do, and lift the torso. So up two, down two. Leave the hips on the ground. At first it doesn't feel like much, but you get there really quick. This is a nice way to isolate each individual tricep. Not individual tricep, group. Muscles on the individual arm. Anyways, you get the gist. typically with dips and tricep push-ups, I see people really struggle with form because triceps tend to be not our strongest muscle. But this way, there's really no hiding the work. It's all right there in the tricep in the back of the arm, yes? Hopefully you feel it. Singles, up, down, let's go. Push and down. I'm never fully coming all the way down, never resting. Four more, if you feel the burn by now. Three, two, and one. Good. We're gonna flip it over to the other side. Then we're gonna stay down for a low plank with glute lifts. Bottom arm tucked under, top arm up, hand in front of the shoulder. Four, three, two. Can you turn up a little bit more, please? Thanks, take it up two. So the elbow's tight to your body, right? It's not pushed out, it's nice and tight. Remember that for future tricep moves, always want the triceps, the elbow's pointing straight back, the arm right next to the torso, if you're trying to work into the triceps. Keep it up. We got a few more of these, and then we're gonna single it out. Up two, down. Start to warm up by now. You need eight singles to really finish up. Yes? Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Two more. Good. Don't let yourself rest. Let's come to a forearm plank. Here's your forearm plank. Low plank. Bring your shoulder blades together. You can drop those knees for a little support, but notice how the hips stay up, and there's very little difference here. We're going to move that leg up and over, up and over, up and over, squeezing through the glutes. Now lift the hips too, and down to plank. One more time, lift up, and pull forward to plank. Let's do those glute lifts. One more each side. Notice my head is up, gazing forward, hips up. Now I look at my feet. Come forward, up, up, forward, glute lift, up and over. Two more. Flatten out that chest. Bring the shoulder blades together, lift up and down. Give me one more set like that. Glute lift. Hips up, hold the hips up, hold them up, hold them up. Drop those knees down and up, down and lift. In fact, walk the feet in a little bit closer if you can. You don't have to fully extend the knee. Relax your shoulders. You got your chin tucked under, ears next to the biceps. Tap the floor with the knees. Down and up. All right, come forward to plank. Then to dolphin. Knees down, knees up. Humble. Hips up, knees down, knees up. Plank. Hips up, knees down, knees up. You got the gist? Four more. Come on, make it happen. Plank. Lift. Down. Up. Two more. Grab your knees, sit all the way back into child. Are you sweating like me? I hope I'm giving that gift to you. I am gonna towel off in 1 second. Good job. All right. All right, we're moving on. We're gonna do a side lunge. Pretty simple. Just like the side lunge, back lunge we did at the beginning, the warm up. Only we're going to add in a reverse fly. So, if you've got weights, grab them. If you don't, it's okay. The key here in a reverse fly, let me show you, is bringing the shoulder blades together. Pushing the shoulders down and bringing the shoulder blades together. The goal in a reverse fly is not to throw the weights behind you. It's gliding the shoulder blades together. Stay in that tree hugger position, yes? We're gonna step out to a nice, big, right lunge. And we're gonna triple that squeeze in the reverse fly. Step it out. Three, squeeze. Step it in, step out the other side. Nice big side lunge. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Good, good. Think about the movement being initiated right in that middle back. Yes? Middle to upper back. It's not initiated from the hands throwing the weights back. That's not where the movement should begin or end or where the focus should be. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Squeeze. Should already feel them. I do. Don't need much weight here. Squeeze. Good. Squeeze. Get a couple more. A little bigger step. A little tougher squeeze. Three more. Woo! Feel it. Three. Nice. Shake it out for a second. One little tip. If at some point you feel yourself struggling and you feel like in order to get there, you have to jerk your body around, that's a signal that you need to drop some weight, take a rep off, make a different modification. So you don't want to force yourself in a position. All should be very, very controlled when we're working into our strength here. So, all right, we're gonna do curtsy. A curtsy squat lunge. We're gonna use weights, we're gonna press down, and then we're gonna lift, either lifting weights overhead with either the toe stepping out or a whole side leg lift. Now the curtsy lunge is awkward. That's all there is to it. I want both toes pointing forward. What tends to happen is people let the hips come out and the back toe turn out. I want you to correct that. I want you to turn things forward. Squared hips and shoulders, back toe pointing forward. The feet are fairly close together. Not a lot of distance. Grab your weights. We're gonna sink those hips all the way down. Go down two. Up and extend. Down. Up and extend. Relax your shoulders on that lift. Relax your grip. You should not be over gripping the weight here. Just let it kind of sit in your palm between your thumb and forefinger. And we're going to do a few more of these and then we're really going to get in the hip with a little sequence. So we're not quite done with this. Two more. Good. Take it down to that curtsy and pulse it. Good. Toes forward. Hips forward. Get a little deeper. Alright. We're going to take it. Curtsy. Back lunge. Lift. Back lunge. Curtsy. Back. Lift. Back. 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 Lift. Bend both knees here. Here, lift, bend, down, down, up, down. Good. Last one, stay back. Stay back, lift and squeeze. Pulse it. Flex the foot, squeeze through the glute. Stick with me. Four, three, two, and one. Nice. Right there, yes? Hopefully, go to the other side. We'll start at the top. Four, three, two, sink low, curtsy down two. Keep the chest up at all times, heads up, shoulders down, long spine. And that side leg lift should feel a little harder than the other side. Good. without a mirror. Two more. I don't have one either. So I hope I'm doing it right. Take it down and pulse it. Pulse it. Just hold on to those weights. Curtsy, back lunge, glute lift, back lunge, stay low, low, lift, low, sink down, down, up and down, push through the floor, press, press, lift, three more, that right hip is burning, hopefully by now, lift and hold, lift and hold. Pulse. Stay with me. Four more. Four. Three. Two. And one. Nice. Whee! Time for a little drink. So we move on. Let's see what else we have. Oh. I've got a good one. We just got those legs. I'm so glad. I thought I was running out. But no, no. Rest assured, there's always more to be done. All right. So we're going to do a push-up. Some more narrow push-up to a renegade row. So push-up, row. Push-up, row. Then we're going to step wide into a sumo and overhead press or just punch the arms, sitting the hips low, right? So you can not use any weights here. You can just lift the elbow with no weight, or you can add the weight to the row and then leave the weights on the ground because that overhead press starts to get really tough. Get ready. Hands on the weights or not. Get your plank. Push up, right row. Keep those hips steady. Push up, left row. Step the feet in, sit low, overhead press, hands down, feet back, push up left row, push up right, squeeze your glutes, that'll stabilize your torso, step it in, overhead press, weight in the heels, arms down, feet back, push up right row, push up left, step it in right left, overhead press, arms down, feet back, push up, left row, come on, stick with me, you're nearing the end, step it in, overhead press, take it down and back, one more on each side, push up, right, push up, left, step it in, low, chest up, one more set, make it happen, push up, row, push up, row, step it in, overhead press, come all the way up, woo, that is a good one, yes, all right, let's do a little bit more balance. Do sort of a hinging motion. We're going to tip over to warrior one. I'm going to hold one weight. You don't need to hold the weight at all to get some nice work through the whole core here. And then we'll sit it down and do some more intense core. But we're going to take it forward here on the right leg. You're going to tip it forward, lifting that back leg. The key here is your lever, head to heel. So I'm here, 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 or here. You don't have to be all the way in this position. Maybe you're here, but you're not here. Don't let it collapse, okay? So we're gonna drop, then we're gonna lift the biceps by the ears, drop, and then rise up. Watch me. On four, three, slight bend in that standing leg. Hinge, lift. Now I'm doing this on carpet, I don't know about you. But it's basically like doing this movement in sand. Makes that balance way harder, yes? Much bigger challenge. And I'm not afraid of the word challenge. used to, nor should you be. Down, lift. Two more, then we're gonna switch the legs right away. We're almost there. Other side. Down and lift. Woo, there you go. Great. So get a little bend in that standing leg. That's really gonna help with the balance. Sometimes it takes a second, don't worry. If you tumble or fall, if you don't, you're probably not challenging yourself sufficiently, right? I always say there's no shame in it. If you stumble and fall, I know that you're really working. Two more. Last one. Good. Shake it out. Whew. All right. We're going to take it back down to the mat. All right. 1 second. Arm or none. Your legs straight up. Flex the heels to get some length through the leg. Arms are straight up. You're going to rest your head down. And if you need to, you're going to bend those knees a little bit. Wherever you need to. We're going to take opposite arm and leg down. So left leg, right arm. Right leg, left arm. Come down. Pop up nice and controlled. Feel like you're pressing through water. Really press. Don't just drop the weight of the leg down. Move through space very intentionally. Really straighten those legs if you can. Pick it up. Loosen that grip. Last two like this. We're gonna up the ante a little bit here. Double them up, both arms. Both legs. Don't hit the ground. Really challenge yourself here. Push that low back into the mat. Very good. Four more. Come on. Make them strong. Only three more. Two more. Last one. Drop those weights. Rock it all the way up. Towel off if you need to. We've got one strong move left. We're gonna do a three-level bird dog. And don't worry, I'm gonna give you modifications. But it's gonna be high plank to low plank to super leg. And all we're doing is lifting opposite arm and leg. So watch me first. We do single. Single, take it down, press, chest forward, gaze forward, all the way down, lift, lift, press it up, join me, take it halfway, lift, keep those hips flat, glutes are strong, you're one board rising up, tighten everything before you lift, right here, keep everything tight, don't relax. Levitate. Halfway. Reach. Reach all the way down. Couple more sets of these guys. Then you're done. Reach. Reach. Halfway. All the way. Reach. Reach. Lift. Last set. Flatten yourself out. Reach and reach. Good job. Sit back to child's pose. Knees are wide. Round out the back. Reach the arms nice and long. Really stretch through the shoulder, the upper back, and the chest. Deep breaths in and out. All right. Take that right leg forward. Now, we're in a low lunge with the knee down. I want you to imagine someone has a strap behind that front ankle, and it's behind your front knee, and it's pulling you forward. And someone has a grab to your back foot, and they're pulling you back. Lengthen. Really feel it through the quadricep and the hip flexor. Of course, the front hamstring too. Press into it. Take it all the way back to that hamstring stretch. Flex the back foot. Deep breath. Forward fold. Long spine. Relax your shoulders. Slight bend in the knee. Take it all the way forward. Grab that foot. Slide it over. Sit into your pigeon. So this is the back leg is straight. Front knee is bent. And the foot, front foot is by the opposite hip. Now, if this is challenging for you, a modification is just to set the hips down and stagger the legs. And then fold forward to get some more intensity through your hip. Rise it up. If you want to, you can intensify the stretch by grabbing for that back foot, opening the chest to the side, feeling it through your quadricep and hip flexor again. I'm sweating, I hope you are too. Release, bring those knees together. Sit back in child's pose one more time. Bring your left leg forward. Same thing, stretching. Lengthening, tall through the spine, lifting the head up, firming your front core. Nice and proud, as you should be if you joined me today. Not so much if you were just watching. You can do it later. Sit back. There's no pretense to this kind of workout, it's just hard work, but very effective. Even if you're using no weights at all, if you're engaging in the target muscle, you will make a difference. That I promise. Take it all the way forward, bend that foot over, sit back, sit into that side hip stretch. Deep breath in and out. Come all the way down. Remember, you can stagger those legs, sit the hips down. Lift, and you can grab that back foot, open the chest to the side wall. This is like a threefer. You've got the front hip, the quadricep and hip flexor, and the front shoulder and pecs. Bring the knees together. This time you can keep the hips in the air. You're going to take your right arm, thread it under, press the bottom shoulder down, then lift the chest to the side wall, press that bottom shoulder down. You should be stretching through the back of the shoulder here. Lift it up, let's switch sides, thread the other arm under. Get on your fingertips and open the chest to the side wall, pressing the bottom shoulder down, lengthening through the neck. Rise up, just sit down, deep breath in. I want you to open to the side wall, pressing the back shoulder back. Take it back up, rotate to the other side. And that's the end of our music. Let's just grab down in child's pose and lift the arms up. You can pull to one side and then the other. Press the shoulders down. Press the hands up. Relax. Roll it up. Flex your feet. Roll back. Roll it all the way up. Wide stance. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. One more deep breath. Exhale. And that is it for strength today, guys. Join me. I think I'm going to do another HIIT high intensity interval workout on Wednesday. Keep tuned. If this worked out okay, we'll have to see how the camera works. was doing and the sound and everything else. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. If you could participate, I'm thrilled and I would love any feedback that you have. Thanks, guys.